there's more similarity between the arts and the sciences than I think most people imagine. Science is about trying to explore the unknown. And to do that, you need to look at the world in a different way. And that's what artists do.
The art of discovery involves someone who is willing to question current paradigms, to look and evaluate what a current clinical problem is, and then apply scientific method to try and resolve that issue.
It all starts with passion, the same passion to achieve something, whether it be in the fundamental discovery, the unraveling of a gene, or to, you know, craft a metaphor in a way that's never been crafted, or to structure a piece of music or a painting in ways that haven't been done before.
So you have to be creative. You have to be thinking about questions that nobody else has ever asked.
We never know what we're going to find. It's like this remarkable opportunity of discovery. And it's just amazingly exciting.
I'm a director of the Institute, so I'm involved in trying to make sure that everything is working well. We keep our scientists and their trainees happy. And the second part of my job is I also run a lab, and so that sort of keeps me interested in the forefront of various areas of research. It's a relatively young research institute. It was established in 1985, and the founding director was Lou Siminovich. He's a very, very famous geneticist. Lou had been in a succession of very important leadership roles in Canada in research, and largely in Toronto. So he was able to assemble this remarkable cadre of scientists. The function really of the Institute and the scientists is to understand ourselves better, and through that understanding, act upon improved treatments or earlier detection of disease, understanding what are the mechanisms which cause the diseases.
The research I do focuses on patients who have more than one chronic condition at a time. So it's a huge challenge, and one that I came upon through experience as a clinician, and then devoted my last 15, 20 years of research to try to figure this out.
We've been interested in diabetes for decades, and our major interest has been with respect to the long-term complications of diabetes.
The fundamental research question that I'm asking is, why do individuals get certain kinds of autoimmune diseases? And I work on some specific diseases. Rheumatoid arthritis is one good example. So my research really spans the area of genetics and immunology. We're really lucky now, and I would use this as an argument why there's never a better time to support research. The technology is just unprecedented in terms of how powerful it is now that you can actually get closer and closer to really addressing the question and taking your basic research right into the clinic.
My interest is in how the placenta forms and the diseases that result from the placenta being damaged or not forming correctly. So this organization is doing wonderful research, and in doing so is creating tomorrow's leaders. This is a highly influential organization.
I've always tell my students that it's a great time to be in research, and I've said that for the past 30 years, and it's been true for the past 30 years.
The great thing about donor funding is it allows us to be more flexible, more nimble. It allows us to think out of the box. And I think that really is where the sparks of innovation occur that allow us to, you know, make the breakthroughs that we need to.
Again, it comes into play, the role of our donations help us to be more creative. Science feeds upon that creativity, and I think that's what makes Lunenfeld-Tanenbaum so successful.